So hello my dear students. Now next point we are going to learn, that is about the questions. I will learn about the contact forces and non-contact forces. Now about the pressure. What is the pressure? And we are observing winds and storms are causing. Because of the winds, storms or cyclones are there. Because of that many villages are there. Or many roofs of the homes are there. You know that houses are there. They are blowing by the wind or cyclones. So here these cyclones are there. Carry out or that is because of the air force and pressure. And so that is, as you know, these are causing, that is because of the difference between the air. As in the air pressure in some areas more and some areas less. That is because it causes cyclones, wind or storms. We are facing that many times. So if the relation between the pressure and force about that, here also we are going to see now. So what is about the pressure? What is the pressure? And you know that sometimes when you are taking a nail and when anything you want to hang on the wall, that time you are taking a hammer and here you are going to see that and pushing the nail into the here, that is into the wall. So with the help of a hammer. Now if you are taking the, this is the nail. Nail you are taking the, and what the nail, as you know, this is the head and this is the back side or tail side. This head side is there. When you want to, you have to see like this, you are holding the and pushing. Is it possible that from head side nail is going inside immediately or easily? Or this is okay, which is a good one or which is an easier one? So here you are applying more and more pressure, but also it is not out, that means it is not inserting inside the wall. And here we can apply the force, as the pressure is causing on that nail, on that pressure, because of that pressure is there, it falls on the wall, and so the nail is moving inside. See, try to push a nail into a wooden plank by its weight. Any wooden plank, benches are there, otherwise the table, stairs are there. So take a nail and the head of the nail is there, try to push that nail into that plank. Is it possible? No. Or is it easier? No, it is not easier. But if you are taking a, here another side of the nail, try to now push the nail by your pointed end. If you are taking a pointed end and you have to, if you are pushing that nail into inside the wooden plank. Could you do this in a time? So yes, we are able to do that. Now take a knife. So sharp side is there and blunt side is there. Now blunt side, you are able to possible cutting of the vegetables or fruits. Or from the sharp side. The sharp side is there, very easier. But the blunt side is there, the vegetables are not cutting. So here, do you get the feeling that area of which the force is applied? With an example of the pointed nail, plays a role in the making the task easier. The pointed nail is there, making task easier one. So that is nothing but the knife example is there, otherwise the nail example is there. The pointed area is there, on that pointed area, that force we are giving on the nail and the pressure causing by the pointed area onto that wooden plank, and so the nail is moving inside and the wooden plank is easy. That is nothing but the what is the pressure, the force acting on a unit area of the surface. Force is there acting on a unit area, small area, only small area is there, that much force is there exerting and so pressure. And that is nothing but the force acting on a unit area of a surface. On the surface, the force which I am giving by person on that, the force acting on a unit area of the surface is the exerting and that is nothing but the pressure. So pressure is equal to the force acting on the unit area on which it acts. So that is called as the pressure. So at this stage we consider only those forces which act perpendicular to the surface on which the pressure is to be computed. So this force is the perpendicular to the surface. This is called as a perpendicular. So the force is there acting on the perpendicular to the surface. And also you are observing that here coaters are there on the like as you know on the many areas like the that cloth, the golden cloth is there on that, and so the pressure will come on that. The pressure will be exerting only on that cloth directly. And so because of that, there is a balancing is there, and that radio is there on that, the pressure is falling there. So here, when they have to carry the load, something is to increase the area of contact of the load with the head. So they are increasing the area of the contact with the load with the head. So head area is this much, but with the help of the cloth, the area of coming contact with the load is increasing. So so the pressure on the head is reduced. The pressure on the head is there, it is reducing, and they find it easier to carry the load. So because of that, the robots are using the portal carrying the heavy load.
And the way they need plastic pipe is there for that plastic.
As you know, rubber sheet is there. If it increases in size, it's a size or not, that we are going to observe. So slowly, if a small percentage of the water is there, less one or one fourth of the water, if you are filling, that one increasing the pressure, and so small, slowly, there is a rubber sheet increasing the size. As you go on increasing the water level, there is it goes on increasing. The means if water is there, more filling the in the more water is filling, means rubber sheet is increasing the size. So you are observing that as the height of the water column in the pipe is there, that you should observe. How you are adding the water in that rubber here into the plastic pipe or in tube, pour some more water, again bulge in the rubber sheet and height of the water column in the pipe. So there you are observing that bulging the rubber sheet is there, it increases in the size. How you are increasing the height of the water? In this process, we are observing that in process a few more times, we are going to see that there is amount of the bulge in the rubber sheet and the height of the water column in the pipe. How you are increasing the height of the water like that, the bulging of the rubber sheet is there, it goes on increasing. So pressure exerted, here the pressure is exerted by water at the bottom of the container depend on the height of the column. So pressure is exerted here, and it depends on the height of the column of that. So pressure exerted by water on the bottom of the rubber sheet is there, or by the container depend on the height of its column. How much height is there of that water? Like that, pressure is exerting on the rubber sheet, and rubber sheet is there, it is swallowing or increasing in the size. So here, the water pressure is there, increasing. One layer of the big pressure exerted by the liquid. Liquid pressure is exerting here, pressure exerted by water at the bottom of the container. It depends on the height of its column. How much height of the column is there? On that, the pressure of the liquid is there, it is dependent. Another instrument is there, an activity is there. Take a plastic bottle, as water bottles are there in your home. Take that one, and here, for the plastic bottle, put a box like this. Plastic bottle is there, one hole appears for that, and in that, another one, take a plastic pipe, and insert that. In the make a hole for the water and take a balloon and here fix that balloon for the water. Now this is the idea of the experiment, that is the activity there. Now fill the water here. You are going to fill the water. So how you are going to fill the water? The water is going inside the balloon and exerts pressure on that balloon. How much you are going to fill the water, and that will be increasing the balloon area. You are observing now, there is a increasing the area of the balloon. Cover the mouth of the glass tube with a thin rubber sheet and you see the activity. Now fill the water up to the half with water. What we observe, right, that the rubber sheet fits into the glass tube bulge this time. So, you are observing that water does not leak from the joint, and if there is a here, cover the mouth with a glass tube and see the liquid pressure or water pressure which is exerting on the balloon. Pour some more water into the glass bottle. Is there any change in the bulge of the rubber sheet? The rubber sheet of balloon which you are arranging here, there is a liquid, a liquid exerts pressure on the wall of the container. Then, if you know that liquid always out of that container. So like that, here liquid takes up the pressure of the wall of the container. Here the wall of the container. Now rubber sheet is there or balloon is there. On that you are observing that rubber sheet is a solid or included in the side. The rubber sheet has been fixed on the side of the container and not at the bottom. So the bulging of the rubber sheet inside the case indicates the water exerts a pressure on the sides of the container. So rubber sheet is there, increasing or swelling is there, or here it indicates that rubber sheet indicates that exerts a here when bulging of the rubber sheet is there. The rubber sheet is a bulging is swelling the or increasing in the here. Is it increasing in the size that here that we see when we will observe that one, it indicates that there is the exerts a pressure on the wall of the container. Another one activity we are observing, as you know, take a bottle and here on that bottle make a from four side holes and fill the water now into the bottle. You are observing that here from all side water will come out. So that is nothing but the liquid enters the equal pressure at the same depth. When same depth is there, that an equal pressure is there. So as if here is the wall, again here having the that time less pressure is there. Then equal depth of when we are taking the liquid exerts the equal pressure at the equal side. When different sides are there, it has a pressure is a different one. So liquid exerts the pressure at the same height also. Take an empty plastic bottle and see, observe that drill the holes around the near bottom to the water. Same height. Make sure that the holes are at the same height. Now fill the bottle with water. You are observing that here water will come out at the holes at the same distance from the water. So you are observing that water will come out from that holes and it will fall at the same distance. Means here liquid exerts the pressure at the here same depth. Liquid exerts. So by these all experiments, that is by the rubber sheet, that is the pressure exerted by the water, and that is because of the height of its column, and on that rubber sheet there is a pressure exerted. That experiment is there. Otherwise, the experiment of the here, the liquid exerts pressure on the wall of the container is there. Otherwise, here, liquid exerts equal pressure at the same depth when you are taking. For that, also, it is there. You are observing all these other instances are telling that liquid exerts pressure on the wall of the container. So, do you have here? Do all gases. So, this is about all liquids. Are all activities that we saw, that is about the activities related with the liquids. Now, activity related with the gas. As gases also exerting the pressure on the wall of the container, or gases are also exerting the pressure or not, that we are going to see. Now, as you know, you are taking a balloon, inflate the balloon. When you are inflating a balloon, you are holding the mouth, tying that one with the mouth thread or anything. Otherwise, what will happen? The air comes out, that is because of the air pressure. See, if you are here filling the balloon with air, inflating the balloon, that time balloon is there increasing with the size. When you are piercing the, that time the air pressure is there, that air, by that air pressure, air will come out. And you are observing so. So, while you are closing the mouth of the balloon, it is necessary to close the mouth of the balloon because air has a pressure. What happens when you open the mouth of the inflated balloon? Suppose we have balloon which has a hole. So, if balloon has a hole, you are able to fill the balloon with or inflate the balloon? No, it is not possible. Can we say that air exerts pressure in all directions? Yes, air is also exerting a pressure. If, as I told you, if balloon has a piercing hole, air will exert a, or if it has a pressure, also balloon from that air will come out. So, as you know, for your bicycle, rubber tires are there. So, you will feel the air into that. It becomes a very harder one. Air exerts a pressure on that wall of the tires are there for that. If air is less, that time it is a very soft one. Means, here, as in the bicycle too, when it has a puncture, that time coming the out on that tire. So here do the observation suggest that air exerts the pressure, air is exerting, and while tire is a pool of air, that time it becomes a very harder one. The air is exerting pressure on the wall of the tire. Also balloons are there, or when for the balloons when their holes are there, we are not able to fill the balloons. Means that air has also pressure. Gases to exert the pressure on the wall of the container. This means that gases are also exerting the pressure by the balloon example, otherwise bicycle tires examples we are taking, it shows that the gases also exert the pressure here on the wall of their container. Next one is there. Now about the atmospheric pressure. As you know, what is atmosphere? Atmosphere is nothing but the air which is present all around us. That is the envelope of air. That is nothing but the atmosphere. What is atmosphere? The envelope around us. The air which is present all around us. That is called as the atmosphere. Atmosphere is present at some height of the earth. It will not present. Means as we go higher up in the space, there is no any air. So here air molecules are present at some height only. So this envelope of air is there, that is called as the atmosphere. Air is envelope of the air which is present around the earth, that is called as the atmosphere. The atmosphere air extends up to many kilometers above the surface of the earth. And so this atmosphere air is there, we are observing that it is present at some up to some kilometers from the height of the from the surface of the earth. It is present. The pressure exerted by the air is known as the pressure of the air. Air has also pressure. That is, as you know, the air is nothing but the air molecules which are present. Which are present. Air around us is called as the atmosphere. The envelope of air. And the pressure which is exerted by the air. Pressure is exerted by air means air has the molecules are there. The molecules are there, the force of gravity is there, and so it exerts the gravity. Gravity is there, exerting on that air. So pressure is present and force is there, which is present on that air molecules and on per unit area. What is the pressure? Force on divided by area which are on that air. So area is there everywhere. Force is acting, force of gravity is there, which means on that air molecules, on the air molecules, see in the atmosphere, air is present, and so air molecules on that force of gravity is there, it will act on that molecules, and so because of that, it has a pressure. So the pressure is exerted by the air, and so air is exerting the pressure, and that is called as the atmospheric pressure. The pressure is exerted by the air exerts a pressure, and that pressure is called as the atmospheric pressure. We know that pressure is there is a force per unit area, and we know that force acting per unit area or force per unit area. Force is there on per unit area, that is called as the pressure. So if we imagine unit area and a very long cylinder standing on it filled with the air, then the force of gravity on the air in this cylinder is the atmospheric pressure. So, if we imagine a unit area of a very long cylinder, see here one activity figure diagram in the presentation 11.17. On that, if you are taking a cylinder and if you imagine that there is a here, air is present in that. If we imagine a unit area, a very long cylinder, take a long cylinder, imagine a long cylinder. It filled with the air, and this filled with air, and that is then the force of gravity on the air in this cylinder is there. Force of gravity on the cylinder, that is called as the atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure is the force of the gravity on the air exerting in the column in a unit area. Here, but how large or small is the atmospheric pressure? But how much it is larger or smaller, that atmospheric pressure, about that we are going to see. As you know, you are taking suckers in the many times in the you are observing that there is a suppress order. Something you are taking and playing with that, you are throwing that one and doing the stitch there. Then these suppress are there and here. If it's stuck or you will stick there with the help of that. Like this suppress are there and that suppress are there. It will stuck up or it will stuck there on the wall or any wall is there on that. So, here take a good quality rubber sucker. The suckers are made of upper rubber only. So, take a good quality upper rubber sucker. It looks like a small rubber cup. Press it hard on a smooth plain surface. Does it stick to the surface? Now, try to pull off the surface. See, good quality upper sucker take. And place it back here. Press on that hard smooth surface. Hard. Press it hard on a smooth plain surface. So, place it hardly on the smooth plate surface. Take a sucker and place it on the smooth plate surface. Then we are observing that sucker is there, it is stuck for the wall. How much nicely you are going to place it hard. Then, now pull that. So, pull that sucker like this. If you are stretching, then pull that. Is it immediately coming out in one hand? No. Means how much possibility that you are going to fix it. Why the sucker is just fixing there? The air in there comes out. The air from that sucker. The sucker which comes in contact with the, this is the sucker. Imagine this is the sucker. The sucker comes in contact with the wall that time. This rubber sucker is there. When we will place it, that the air is there. In that place it goes out. Air is there. It is not present that time. And it will fix it. That time, the atmospheric pressure is there on that sucker, it will cause. So, when you place the rubber sucker, most of the air between the cup and the surface escape out that way. See, here, when you place the sucker on the wall, that time the air is there, it comes out from the, or it will escape out from that sucker. The sucker sticks to the surface because the pressure of the atmosphere acts on it. And so it will stick because atmospheric pressure is there on that sucker. And so to pull the sucker of the surface, the applied force should be larger enough. When you are pulling the sucker, atmospheric pressure is there, it is larger enough. And so we have to pull more forcibly for that. To overcome the force of the atmospheric pressure, we have to apply a more force and then only the sucker will come. Many times we are observing that the sucker is not pulling suddenly or easily because air is there, it is less of the air which is present in between the wall and the sucker, it is less of it. See, and so because of that, to overcome the atmospheric pressure, here the applied force should be large enough, it is necessary. This activity might give an idea about the magnitude of atmospheric pressure. And so, see how much atmospheric pressure is there. Sucker means what will happen? The rubber sucker is just stuck there or here. It will stuck there on the wall that can air come out from there. But when it will stuck there, the atmospheric pressure is there. It will fall on that sucker. And so, the sucker will not come out when we will pull hard. Because of the air is there from that area, it will move out. Imagine some air only moves out from that surface itself. But here, this activity might give an idea about the magnitude of atmospheric pressure. How much magnitude is there for the atmospheric pressure? That activity will tell you that what is the atmospheric pressure about that you are understanding here. See, atmospheric pressure is there, it is more. And so because of that, sucker is there, it is stuck for the wall, it will not come out. We have to make it possibly or very hardly we have to pull it. If imagine that in fact it would not be possible for any human being to pull the sucker off the surface in there, it will be no in all between the sucker and the surface. The surface and wall. Sucker. The air is not there. It is very hard to remove the sucker from that. So some air is present and so we are able to here pull the sucker. But if there is no any air in between the like that if you are applying then it is very hard or here it is not possible to pull out that sucker here. Does it give an idea of Atmospheric pressure is everywhere. On our head axis it is present. As air molecules are present around us, on our head axis it is present. So atmospheric pressure is there, we are observing on our head axis. So if we are imagining that a pressure of atmosphere on our head, then it will cancel in now. Because the pressure is there exerting by our body also. And so the both pressures are there. They are linear, equal angle. So when they are equal, we will cancel it out there. Pressure exerting by our body actually is there and atmospheric pressure. Both are cancelling to each other. So we are not feeling the atmospheric pressure. The force due to the air in the column of the height of the atmosphere, that is the 15 into 15 centimeter, is nearly equal to the force of the gravity. So atmospheric pressure is there. It is nearly the force due to the air in the column of the height of the